자, 이번 영상에는 여러분이 너무나 쉽다고 생각하시는 댐의 발음에 대해서 한번 알아보도록 하겠습니다. 자, 첫 번째는 여러분이 너무나 잘 알고 계시는 댐으로 발음이 나는 경우입니다.
She's an Argent, she's with them. She's an Argent, she's with them.
She's an Argent, she's with them. 이렇게 하죠.
She's an Argent, she's with them.
She's with them. 걔는 아젠트가의 사람이고 그들과 함께 있어. 이런 얘기입니다.
She's an Argent, she's with them. She's an Argent, she's with them. She's an Argent, she's with them. She's an Argent, she's with them.
분명히 댐이라고 들립니다. 댐.
With them. But not one of them. You were with them, but not one of them. You were with them, but not one of them.
You were with them, but not one of them.
You were with them, but not one of them.
댐이 두번 들어가고 있는데 두번다 댐이라고 들립니다. You are with them, but not one of them.
You were with them, but not one with them, but not one of them. You were with them, but not one of them.
You were with them, but not one of them. 두번다 정확하게 댐으로 들려왔습니다. 여러분이 잘 알고 있는 댐. 자, 두 번째는 발음이 듬 이렇게 약해지는 경우에 대한 케이스 소개인데요.
Treat them like the regular girls. You gotta treat them like the regular girls. You gotta treat them like the regular girls.
You gotta treat them like the regular girls.
You gotta treat them like the regular girls.
You gotta는 you've gotta 이겁니다. You've gotta treat them 이렇게 해주죠. 뭐처럼 like the regular girls. 일반 애들처럼, 일반 여자애들처럼 걔네들을 대해야 된다. 이런 뜻입니다. 여기서 them 이렇게 얘기하네요.
Treat them like the regular girls. You gotta treat them like the regular girls. You gotta treat them like the regular girls.
Treat them 이렇게 들리죠, 그죠?
Find them anywhere. Really, you can't find them anywhere. Really, you can't find them anywhere.
You can't find them anywhere.
Really, you can't find them anywhere. Really, you can't find them anywhere.
듬이 약간 약하게 가긴 했는데 you can't find, can이 강하게 들리면 can not입니다. You can't find them anywhere. not하고 any하고 같이 쓰인다 이런 거는 학교 다닐 때 문법 시간에 배운 내용이죠.
Really, you can't find them anywhere. Really, you can't find them anywhere. Really, you can't find them anywhere. Really, you can't find them anywhere.
You can't find them anywhere.
Really, you can't find them anywhere.
You can't find them anywhere. 듬입니다. 듬.
Giuliani had them removed along with the homeless. Giuliani had them removed along
Had them removed. 이건 좀 어려운데요.
with the homeless. Giuliani had them removed along with the homeless.
Giuliani had them removed along with the homeless.
Giuliani had them removed along with the homeless.
듬듬 거리죠. 줄리아니는 예전에 뉴욕시장 이름입니다. Giuliani had them removed along with the homeless. Giuliani had them removed along with the homeless. 노숙자들과 함께 그들을 제거해 버렸다. 이런 뜻입니다.
Giuliani had them removed along with the homeless. Giuliani had them removed along with the homeless.
어쨌거나 지금 예문에서는 듬듬 거린다라는 얘기를 하고 있습니다. 듬듬듬.
So you're saying it's easy to meet them? So you're saying it's easy to meet them?
So you're saying it's easy to meet them?
So you're saying it's easy to meet them?
So you're saying it's easy to meet them? So you're saying it's easy to meet them? Easy to meet them 듬이라고 명확하게 들리죠.
So you're saying it's easy to meet them? So you're saying it's easy to meet them? So you're saying it's easy to meet them? So you're saying it's easy to meet them?
meet them 이렇게 얘기를 했습니다.
Yeah, what about them? Yeah, what about them? Yeah, what about them? Yeah, what about them?
Yeah, what about them?
Yeah, what about them? Yeah, what about them?
Yeah, what about them? 이렇게 하죠, 그죠? 그래, 걔네들 뭐? Yeah, what about them?
Yeah, what about them? Yeah, what about them?
Yeah, what about them? 첫 번째 댐이었고요. 두 번째 듬. 자, 세 번째로는 아예 TH 발음을 날려버리는 경우입니다. 그래서 아무 발음도 없이 그냥 이렇게 TH가 없어지고 이응이 첫 소리입니다. 음으로 가는 경우가 가장 흔하게 들려오는데요.
Did anybody else, any of them, make it? Did anybody else, any of them, make it?
중간에 any of them이 들리죠? any of them.
Did anybody else, any of them, make it?
그죠? any of them이 분명히 들릴 겁니다. Did anybody else? Did anybody else? Any of them? Any of them? Make it? Did anybody else? Any of them? Make it?
Did anybody else, any of them, make it? Did anybody else, any of them, make it? Did anybody else, any of them, make it?
Any of them make it? 물론 음은 이 액센트 강세를 받지 않기 때문에 약해져서 나타나는 현상입니다.
Your dad is one of them. Your dad is one of them.
That is one of them.
Your dad is one of them.
That is one of them. Her dad is one of them. 이렇게 얘기하는 거죠. Her dad is one of them. Her dad is one of them. 걔 아빠도 그 이런 중한 명이야. Her dad is one of them.
Your dad is one of them. Your dad is one of them.
One of them, 그러죠? 자, any of 다음에 댐이 of 그리는 현상을 보내고 있습니다. Any of them, one of them.
It's just two of them. How do we know it's just two of them? How do we know it's just two of them?
이번에도 of와 함께 붙으면서 two of them 이렇게 들렸죠? How do you know? 일단 how do you know니까 how do you know? 너 어떻게 아니? Just two of them. 두 명밖에 없는 것을 어떻게 아느냐?
Just two of them. How do we know it's just two of them? How do we know it's just two of them?
How do you know just two of them?
How do we know it's just two of them? How do we know it's just two of them?
Two of them 이렇게 되죠? 데미였습니다.
Just keep them where I can see them, all right? All right, let's just keep them where I can see them, all right?
Alright, let's just keep them where I can see them, alright?
All right, let's just keep them where I can see them, all right?
자, 이번에는 Let's just keep them where I can see them, alright?
Alright? Alright, let's just keep them where I can see them, alright?
Let's just keep them where I can see them, alright? Where I can see them, alright? Let's just keep them where I can see them, alright?
Just keep them where I can see them, alright? Alright, let's just keep them where I can see them, alright?
Where I can 이런 부분은 지금 안 들려도 상관없습니다. can 발음할 때도 따로 다룰 거니까요. 이 re 발음도 따로 얘기를 할 겁니다. Where I can 이런 거는 안 들려도 상관없고 지금 현재 seem만 들리면 됩니다.
Just keep them where I can see them, alright? Alright, let's just keep them where I can see them, alright?
그것들 내가 보이는 곳에 두자. 알았지? 여기서의 그것들은 양손을 가리킵니다.
Maybe in a whole pack of them. Maybe in a whole pack of them. Maybe in a whole pack of them.
앞쪽 부분 뭐라고 하는지 잘안 들릴 수 있는데 pack of them만 들리면 돼요.
Maybe in a whole pack of them. Maybe in a whole pack of them. Maybe in a whole pack of them. Maybe in a whole pack of them.
자, 앞부분 안 들려도 상관없습니다. 우리가 배운 게 아니기 때문에 안 배운 거, 안 들리는 거 당연한 거잖아요. Maybe even a whole pack of them입니다. pack of them. 자, 이번에도 오브와 함께 했죠? pack of them.
Maybe in a whole pack of them. Maybe in a whole pack of them. Maybe in a whole pack of them.
자, 사운드는 오브와 함께 할때 계속 등장하고 있습니다.
We're gonna take care of them. Well, we're gonna take care of them.
We're gonna take care of them.
Well, we're gonna take care of them. Well, we're gonna take care of them.
We're gonna take care of them. We're gonna 할때 when은 이 아리 발음. 아리 발음 할때 얘기를 한 건데. 자, where 이렇게 갑니다. 요거는 아리 발음에서 다릅니다. 그리고 gonna 그거는 워낙 유명한 be going to고요. We're gonna take care of them. 이번에도 of와 함께 했죠? of them이었습니다. 우리가 그들을 보살필 거야.
We're gonna take care of them. Well, we're gonna take care of them. Well, we're gonna take care of them.
We're gonna take care of them. We are going to take care of them. We are going to take care of them. We are going to take care of them. 이렇게 얘기하는 원어민은 아무도 없습니다. Where, we are보다 where 쉽잖아요. 그리고 going to보다도 gonna 편하잖아요. We're gonna take care of them. We're gonna take care of them. 우리가 걔네들 돌볼게.
We're gonna take care of them. Well, we're gonna take care of them.
We're gonna take care of them.
Why don't you go get them? Why don't you go get them?
Why don't you go get them?
Why don't you go get them?
Why don't you는 그 why don't you인데 그 편하게 하기 위해서 자꾸 하던 얘기니까 why don't you 이렇게 편하게 발음하는 겁니다. Why don't you 동사 뭐냐? 우리는 why don't you, why don't you 이렇게 알고 있는데 why don't you, why don't you, why don't you 이렇게 부드럽게 굴러갈 수도 있죠. Why don't you go get him? Why, 얘는 why don't you처럼 발음을 했습니다. Why don't you go get him, get him 의미였죠. Why don't you go get him? 네가 직접 가서 걔네들 잡아봐봐.
Why don't you go get him? Why don't you go get him? Why don't you go get him? Why don't you go get him?
Why don't you go get him? Why don't you? Why don't you? Why don't you였네요, 그죠? Why don't you라고도 하고 Why don't you 이렇게 발음했습니다. Why don't you go get him?
Why don't you go get him?
Why don't you go get him? 너무 어렵네요. 자, 이거는 대본을 봐도 여러분이 인정을 할 수 있을지를 모르겠지만 You just shoot. 네가 쐈잖아. 애들 중에 한 개. 네가 맞췄잖아, 총으로. 이 말이죠? You just shoot one of them. 이게 just, T는 날리고 just의 S와 shoot의 S가 겹치기 때문에 just shoot 이렇게 지나가니까 안 들리는 겁니다. 요 just 역시 별도 영상 나갑니다. You just shoot one of them. 앞에 안 들려도 상관없어요. 현재로서는 one of them만 들리면 됩니다. 원어맨 마지막 거 들리죠? 원어맨 이즈슈 원어맨 이건 앞뒤 문맥이랑 화면이 있어야지 딱 들어옵니다. 이것만 잘라 들으면 뭔 소린지 안 들리는 게 너무나 당연해요. You're gonna sell them on eBay. eBay는 뭐 옥션 같은 사이트고요. 그것들 옥션에다가 팔아먹으려고
You're gonna sell them on eBay.
You're gonna sell them. Sell them. 또 데미였습니다. On eBay. eBay에다가 팔아먹으려고
You're gonna sell them on eBay.
Sell them 의미였네요. 자, 기본적으로 them, 듬, 중에서 이게 모두 영어가 액센트어기 때문에 나타나는 현상입니다. 강세를 받았을 경우에는 them 이렇게 힘을 받지만 그게 아닌 경우에는 음입니다. 그리고 그 앞에 D 사운드가 있으면 넘어오면서 듬이 되는 거고 그런 거 마저 없으면 음으로 완전히 발음이 무너지는 거죠. 댐듬 음이었습니다. 오브가 있으면 주로 음이었고요. One of them. Care of them, care of them. 이것도 of them인데 이제 K가 올라타니까 pack of them 이렇게 들린 거죠. Pack of them 이런 식으로. 그래서 여러분 보고 뭐 pack of them 이렇게 발음하라고 하는 얘기는 아니고요. 이렇게 걔네들이 할 때 들을 수 있어야 된다. 여러분들이 원어민들, 서양인들 겁내는 이유가 딴 게 아닙니다. 걔네들이 뭐라 말하는지 뭐라고 얘기하는지 못 알아듣기 때문에 거기서 두려움이 발생하는 거예요. 알아들을 수만 있다면 열 마디 알아듣고 내가 하고 싶은 얘기 어설프게라도 한 마디 그 문맥에 맞게 던지면 회화를 잘하는 거죠. 동문서답이 되지 않게 하는 거. 그게 제일 중요하거든요. 그래서 제가 보기에는 영어는 듣기가 제일 중요해요. 제대로 드러내는 거. 물론 정답을 고르는 테스트에서는 이 댐이 뭐 음이냐 댐이냐 이게 중요치 않은데요. 테스트가 아닌 현실 세계에서는 여러분이 이게 댐으로 말을 했다라는 것을 인지할 수 있어야 됩니다. 아시겠죠? 자, 오늘의 발음 댐이었습니다. 댐듬음. 음을 가장 많이 쓰는군요. All of them, one of them, get them, care of them, pack of them, sell them. 감사합니다.